break out tonight. Miracles can happen when you break in and you break out among us.
know, when heaven comes, that means Jesus came. That means Jesus came because Jesus is heaven, amen? If we go to heaven, we don't have Jesus. I don't want to go to heaven. I want to be with Jesus. Thank you, God. You know, I really feel like, I mean, it's the obvious. There is a massive spirit of breakthrough in this room right now. And, I mean, God is just here. You know, when we come up here to close and stuff, it's like, ha, what do I say on this thing? Because this is, God, I don't want to mess this up, man. The presence of God is, let's grab it. But here's what I feel like. There is, I'm going to share a testimony in just a second here, but there is a sound deep on the inside of many of us here, and it's felt locked up for some of you guys for years, for some of you guys for a couple days, for some of us for months. But that sound needs to be released. And there's gonna be some things broken tonight. And we're gonna lift up a mighty shout in a few minutes, in a few seconds. We're gonna lift up a massive shout that's likened to the walls of Jericho that are gonna bring the walls down, not outside of you, but inside of us. Amen? We just recently had an amazing weekend here with our Bethel weekend with our family here at the church. And we had a young man come up here and share a testimony that was just so powerful. His name is Simeon, and he's just an amazing young man. But he first showed up at our youth service, our youth ministry, you know, beginning of the school year this last year. And Simeon came in really battling some intense things. He was battling autism, and he would hide under chairs and was just really freaked out by large crowds. He began to get into the presence of the Lord. And then he heard, his dad told me he heard a testimony of three of our teenagers sharing about one of them had cutting scars that dissolved. One of them got set free from pornography, and the other one got set free from fear. And the sound of the presence of God on somebody else's story of how they encountered Jesus did something inside of him. And he continued to come, and the presence of God would just touch him. And then one day he got set free from pornography. And his life just began to shoot. In December, he goes back to the doctor, and the doctor said, "You are totally fine. You don't need your meds anymore." His kid's completely off of his meds, totally set free. And he came up here. Many of you guys were here. He came up here, and he shared his testimony at the conference this last Saturday and was bold. I mean, just going after it, commanding every spirit of autism, pornography, and everything else to just get out of this room. Just going for it. He was killing it. It was awesome. But I was reading Acts chapter 2. It says there was a sound from heaven that came down, and it didn't just fill this pocket over here or this one over here, but it filled the whole room. How many of you guys know you're a house of heaven? He lives on the inside, and he's waiting to be released. Jesus Christ has paid the price for everything needed in this room. He's paid the price for every wall that needs to come down. You're not immune to his grace. You've not blasphemed the Holy Spirit where God, you're just, you know, God's just, he's just, that one gets touched, that one gets, oh, we're gonna skip him. That one. God don't work like that. He's pouring out his glory. He's pouring out his presence. And it's time for us today to grab it by faith. We're gonna lift up a mighty shout and lift our voices in this place. And we're gonna break. Some of you guys be like this. God, I'll shout when the walls come down. You're gonna be waiting forever. The Bible says, faith spoke in tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. You gotta lift your voice. It's called an act of faith. Well, I'm not feeling it. Then be a faith person, not a filler today. Because God wants it for you. And then on a serious, I feel like some of you guys here, you're battling like discontentment. Maybe that marriage didn't work out, or you fail again, or something, the business closed down, or something painful happened, and you're sitting there. Listen, it's time to work through that grief, but in the middle of that place is where you need to begin to get your shout back. It's in that place where you need to begin to grab your joy. In the middle of that place, not waiting till afterwards. Sometimes you just gotta go to war from a place of faith. We're not shouting for victory. We're shouting because we have victory tonight. Amen? So here's what we're gonna do tonight. Listen, I want you to get your praise on. Just get ready. You got your praise pants on. You got your spirit fingers up. I don't know what that is. This sounded fun. Just how many guys are just ready to be unlocked? You're just ready to get unlocked. just ready to unlock it. Listen, the good news is the lock was already transformed 2,000 years ago when Christ rose from the grave. Come on, 1, 2, 3, lift it up. It.
You are the Lord.
Put your hand on the person next to you. Come on, sing it over your neighbor.